गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ चैप्टर रीच फॉर द टॉप। बट बिफोर बिगिनिंग दिस चैप्टर आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क समथिंग टू यू बिकॉज यू आर ग्रोन अप, यू आर अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ 9th क्लास, ओके। And this chapter that is added by NCERT in your syllabus, there is a reason behind this chapter, why this chapter has been added in your syllabus, because there are so many things to be learned from this chapter at this age. If you understood this chapter not in literary terms, but if its meaning is properly clear, only then this chapter will be beneficial for you. So let's begin with the chapter. Reach for the top. You think about some of the, you can say motives, some of the inspiration that are required if you want to reach at the top. You all want to do something in your life or not? Okay. You all are saying yes. You want to do something in your life. So if you really want to do something in your life, you want to reach at the zenith, you can say, you want to reach at the top. So another word for zenith is summit. So if you really want to reach at the zenith, you want to reach at the top, you want to touch that sky, it means you want to be successful in your life, you want to achieve something. So what do you think that which are required, which are very much essential? What do you think? Okay, Renuka has told me, okay, whatever you are telling me, I am going to make a box of this. And whatever the students of 9th class will be sharing with me, I will be making notes of these things. And then I will tell you that you are right at what place. Okay, Renuka has written that if I want to reach at the top, so I require hard work. Only by doing hard work, physical labor, you can attain your goal. One by one, you will be raising your hand, because here I want to mention the name of the student also, so that at any time, if you see the recording, you will come to know, other parents will also come to know, your other classmates will also come to know that this student has which kind of mentality, what is their perspective, what is their opinion. Okay, so Kawar Noor, what do you think? Okay, Kawar Noor has told me it requires determination, Jashan, mental health. Okay. Mental health. Simran? Okay. Simran is saying knowledge and confidence. Saksham? Okay. Willpower. Saksham is saying very good point. Then one requires a willpower. Okay. Prane is saying smart work is required. Akhilesh is telling me about courage. Determination. So these are the points that you all have told me, that hard work, courage, determination, mental health, knowledge and confidence, willpower, smart work, all these, Shivansh. Okay, self introspection. So there are so many things, there is a long list, and this list is too long, that one requires, only then they can achieve high in their life. And for that, I just want to share one thing with you. Think high, aim high, and achieve high. This is a very beautiful logo that I really like. If you really want to achieve something high, only by sitting idle and only by thinking about that, can you achieve that target? No, not at all. So first of all, you have to think high. It means you should think about your goal. Yes, this is my goal. I want to achieve this thing. This is my motive. Okay. Only then you can aim high and you can achieve your goal. Okay. So first of all, what should be in your mind? That what do you want to achieve? Your target should be clear in your mind. Where you want to reach? If you know about your target, only then you can move in that direction. If it is your target, yes, I want to score good marks. My target is to score highest marks in class. So your mission, your target, your vision will be very much clear in front of you. Yes, I want to achieve this thing. This is my motive. I want to score more than 95%. This is my mission of this year. And next year also in 9th and 10th, I want to score more than 95%. So on which direction will you start working? In same direction? You will study hard. You will collect notes. You will be preparing notes. You will be listening to all the teachers carefully. Okay? Because you have a clear vision, clear aim, clear ambition in your mind. So first thing that you have to work, first of all, think about your mission. What you want to achieve. You want to become doctor, you want to become engineer, you want to become any content developer, you want to go for any job, you want to go in IT, you want to go in medical line, you want to go in non-medical line, whatever your target, just think about that. That what is my target? What I want to be in my life? See, there are so many persons in history, they have become so famous at a very early age, at a very young age. Why? Because they have selected their mission at a very early age and they started doing work on that. They were working on those missions. That's why they have become successful at that point. Their targets, their missions, their achievements, their goals, everything was very much clear in their mind. Yes, I want to achieve this thing and I have to go in that direction. They were not beating about the bush. They were not moving here and there. They were not making guesses. They were going in that direction by keeping their vision, by keeping their target in their mind. This is my target. I want to hit on that. If I look here, 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 and here, can I hit on that? No. My target should be only on this point. Only then I can hit on this point. So this is the example that I have taken to make you clear that if you really want to be successful, first of all, make your vision clear and start working on that. When you will be starting working on that, so you will be require these things. You will be requiring courage. You will be requiring hard work, determination, mental health, knowledge, confidence, willpower. You will be requiring self-introspection that how to do that. You have to make balance between all these things, among all these things. For example, there is a chapter of Santosh Yadav. Okay. So it requires only hard work, physical hard work, mental hard work also, spiritual also. You have to make a balance among all the things. Only then you can reach at your targets. You want to score first position. Is it easy? It requires only physical hard work. That you have to burn midnight oil. You have to study day and night. You have to join coaching centers. You have to purchase good books. You have to day and night. You have to work day and night. You have to listen to teachers' lecture. Only this requires. There can be emotional up and down also in your life. Sometimes your family members are enjoying. Your classmates are enjoying. You have to make that emotional balance in you. If they are enjoying, why can't I? But you have to think that it is a time to do hard work. I have to appear in test tomorrow. So if I will be enjoying with my family and with my classmates, how can I score good marks? there can be emotional conflict. So you have to make a balance between your physical energy and your emotional, you can say health, emotional energy also. So many things you have to work on that. Only physical stamina is not sufficient. So there were so many people, they had to face different kind of hardships, different kind of obstacles and you can say troubles in their life, but hurdles in their life, but they worked on that. It doesn't mean that their life was very smooth. Their family was with them and they achieved their target. They became famous. They got World Cups. They got their medals, trophies. No, they were having so many difficulties in their life, but they maintained a balance. They fought with those problems and they shone just like a star. They proved themselves and now their names are in our books. We are reading their chapters. Their names are written in Google. Their names are written in history. And they have become famous. They were not different. They were like us. But their mental level, how to face the problem, how to cope up with the problem. They were having a fixed aim in their life. They went in that direction without moving, without looking back. There could be some moments when they thought, no, I should leave it in between. I should go back. There could be some moments. But how did they work on that? How did they achieve their target? How did they become successful? This is all about that chapter. Okay? So let's read about this chapter. Santosh Yadav. Okay? And in this chapter, it is also told that they were having some idols also in their life. See, there can be some famous personality to whom you really like. And these famous personalities are your idols. Idols means they are your role models. You want to be like them. Because these idols, these role models have achieved something in their life. Why are they favorite of yours? Because of their qualities, because of their achievements, because of their identity in society, in country or in nation, okay? Because they are your favorite. Why they are your favorite? What thing did you notice in that? So in your notebook, make a list of near about 3-4 person. You think that these are role models for you and you want to be like them. You want to be like them. It can be your father, it can be your mother also. It can be any actor, it can be any sports person, it can be any leader. So make a list, don't see title, take out your notebooks, start making list and discuss it with me. Irrelevant question when they ask. So make a list of any 3 or 4 you can also make. Make a list of 3 to 5 person you think that you really admire them. You are really inspired by them. These are the sources of inspiration for you. You want to be like them. Who are they? Who are they? Hurry up, tell me. Anyone you can tell? Huh? Okay, Jashan is saying father. His father is idol. Mother. Jashan is saying mother. Okay, why do you admire your mother? Okay, Jashan is inspired with her mother. Why so? Because she thinks her mother is hardworking, very much laborious. She works continuously. Okay. So she is very much energetic, enthusiastic member of the family. So because of her qualities, she likes her and she admires her a lot. Good, very good point. Simran. So for Simran Gakkar, Kiran Bedi is her idol. She has a very good experience because she has interacted with her also. So here she wants to tell why Kiran Bedi is her idol.
Hi. So my idol is Dr. Kiran Bedi, ma'am. Maybe you have watched the live, maybe not, but for me, it was really a pleasant experience. It was my first time going live with such a great personality, and her perspective, her point of view, her opinions, her IQ level. It was just, she is such a courageous and hardworking woman. And first of all, you should just believe in yourself. What you can do, no one can do for yourself. So my ideals are like 3 to 4, like Dr. Kiran Bedi, ma'am, my dad. My dad really is, he has like all the qualities that a leader has. He takes the lead and always achieves success, and may God always make him move forward. And Charli D'Amelio, I watch dancing like videos, and I sing, but my interest is in dancing too. And BTS, all time favorite. Because their singing skills, the looks, most in teenagers, their looks matters the most. So they tells us to love ourselves. And that is the thing that I admire the most about them. Thank you.
Very good. So Charli, BTS, these are the Korean boys, I think so. Yes. Korean. So they have become so famous. So these all are her idols. So Simran has shared a very good knowledge. And another one you want to tell. So you also make a list of 3 to 4 persons whom you really like, who are idols for you, and you want to be like them. Online students also make a list. Okay, make a list of online students. Aryan, Dhiren, Ikjot. Aryan, Dhiren, Ikjot, Jayati, Parmeet, Ritik, Aman, Sudiksha, Sumati. Okay, now let's discuss about those idols. Tell me others also. Only Jashan and Simran have told. You don't have any idol in your family. You don't have any idol in your society. Son. Okay. Okay. According to Commander Vivekananji. So you can you behave like him? Can you sit at rest for a while? You like that person, you admire that person. So you should learn from his teachings. Any one teaching can you tell about?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Once upon a time, he traveled from a train to a particular
planet. And Kavanur wants to tell something about Vivekananda because he admires that great holy personality saint a lot. No problem. Bache, no problem. In English class, you have to interact, you have to learn. Come here.
My role model of my life is Vivekananda ji. because in some book I read about him that once upon a time he traveled from a train to Birmingham to London. In that train there were two ladies were sitting behind him, and she looked on Vivekananda ji that what his personality, because he wear a chola like sons and sitting, but they have a very costly watch on his right hand. The girls was impressed by his watch, and they wanted to snatch that watch. And Vivekananda said they told to Vivekananda ji that gave that watch to me, and if you don't give me that watch I will ask to police that this person was characterless, and he was not a good person. And Vivekananda behaved like a deaf person. They tell that I cannot hear. They tell in writing that I cannot hear. Please tell what you are wanted to say to me in writing. And those ladies write that if you don't give your watch, I will tell to the policeman that you are collectorless. And Vivekananda said that lay out police. Vivekananda said that now you can go to the police station and ask the police, I am characterless. That his viewpoint is different from others, and he always makes the solving the problems in out of the way, outstanding way. That's why he was my role model of my life.
So he has told a very beautiful story that he liked that person because of his intellectual, because of his wisdom, that he, how did he handle the case so smartly? Because of his intellect, he became so famous. Okay, so that was all your experience. You have shared your experience. Now in this chapter, we are going to read about Santosh Yadav. Santosh Yadav is a very famous woman, okay, who has reached Mount Everest, and he took a birth in such kind of society where you can say sun was regarding as a blessing, where sons were given so much importance, but daughters were not given so much importance. So he was born in such kind of society where sons were given importance. At the time of son, there were celebrations, but at the time of daughter, there was no celebration. Okay, pin drop silence was there. People became so sad, and there was completely gloominess in their surrounding. So in such kind of environment, in such kind of family, she took up birth. So how did she become so famous? How did she achieve her goal to scale on Mount Everest, to reach at that summit? So it was really, you can say, a praiseworthy thing. So let's read about Santosh Yadav. The only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing, and a daughter, though not considered a curse, was not generally welcome. When her mother was expecting Santosh, a traveling holy man giving her his blessing assumed that she wanted a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. The holy man was also surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessing, and as destiny would have it, the blessing seemed to work. Santosh was born the sixth child in a family with five sons. See, it means when Santosh Yadav's mother was pregnant, okay, she was expecting a baby. So at that time, there was one of the holy men. So holy man said that you want blessings from me. What kind of blessings you want? That I should bless you, that you should have a son. Okay, because they were already having 5 son. So Santosh Yadav was going to be 6th child. So grandmother was also grandmother of Santosh. She was also standing beside and she said, no, we don't want such kind of blessings to have another son. Because what do we want? We want blessings of a daughter. So when holy man listened this thing, that particular lady and her grandmother, they did not want such kind of blessing, because everybody in the society, they were wanting such kind of blessings that they should have son. But that lady, she wanted to have blessing that she should give birth to a daughter. So holy man, he got really surprised. Okay, so really happened, what happened, that after 5 brothers, okay, she was born in a small village of Jonia Vas of Rewari district in Haryana. So where did she take birth? In Haryana. And she was having how many brothers?
5.
So she was on the 6th number. She was the 6th child in the family. And she got birth after 5 sons. Clear? So the girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment. Which means contentment. So that girl was given the name Santosh. Another name of Santosh is contentment. Contentment, another word is satisfaction. Another name is satisfaction. So this beautiful name was given to that girl, but Santosh name was given to her. But do you think that she was satisfied with her life? From this second paragraph, you will come to know about her traits, which kind of girl she was when she was a little child. The girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment. But Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. She began living life on her own terms from the start. Where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred shorts. Looking back, she says now, from the very beginning, I was quite determined that if I chose a correct and a rational path, the others around me had to change, not me. So in this paragraph, we have come to know that girl was given a name Santosh. It means satisfaction. It means contentment. But Santosh was not satisfied, always content with the place, because she was born in a very traditional, you can say orthodox, you can say such kind of family. Okay. And when she was about to start her age, she understood, okay, what to wear, what, okay, in which sense we should get up, we should dress up. So when other girls of her age, they were wearing traditional dresses. So at that time, she did not like traditional dresses. When other girls of her age, they were wearing traditional dresses, she used to wear shorts. Okay. And from the very beginning, when she was a child, she used to think this thing that I have to choose my own path. I have to choose a correct path. I have to choose a rational path. Rational path means intelligent path that requires your intelligence. Right path. So she wanted to go on a right path, not on a wrong path. And she was saying the person who are around her, they had to change. She would not change. It means she was such kind of girl who wanted to choose her own path, and she did not want to follow the path of others. She was having her own ambitions. She was having on her own desires. Okay. And if she wanted to go on that path and she did not want to change, she wanted that other person, they had to change according to her needs, her desires, her likings, her dislikings. Up to that paragraph is clear. Shall I move further? See, she was not with her family, she was not with her society, because when family and society was going in that path, that you are a girl, you should wear that ghagra cholis. So she was saying, why girls are supposed to wear ghagras and cholis? Why they can't wear shorts? When family and society was telling that you have to do this thing, she was telling why girls are supposed to do this thing, why not boys? So she was having her own mentality, her own viewpoint, her own perspective. So why she was saying, why I have to change myself according to the family, according to the society? She was her own way where she wanted to go. You will come to know about something more about Santosh Yadav when we will be moving to next paragraph. So Santosh parents were affluent. Affluent means very much wealthy. You can say rich. So you can write down the meaning of affluent. Santosh parents, they were very much rich. Land owners, okay. So they could afford to send their daughter to a very good school. They could afford the fees of a very good school, okay. Even they could send their daughter to country's capital, New Delhi also, okay. And that at that time, New Delhi, which was very much near to their village, because they were living in one of the village of Haryana. So they could afford, they could pay her fees, okay, they could, but in time with the prevailing custom of the family, but what was the custom? What was the tradition which was prevailing, which was going on in the family, that Santosh had to make do with the local village school. But according to that time, according to the custom and traditions of that time, girls were not allowed to go for higher studies, to go outside their village. So that's why she had to continue her study only in the village where she was living in Haryana. She was not sent outside. Okay. So, but when she was growing up, she thought about that system. She decided to fight with the system in her own way. And when she became of 16 age, okay. So when at the time of 16, when most of the girls of the village, they were getting married, Santosh was also under pressure. Now she should get married at the age of 16. And her parents also told her, according to the society, that you are now 16 age, your age is 16, you should get married. So did she get married at that age? Due to the pressure of her family, due to the pressure of society, did she get married? No. So we will come to know something more in next class. Okay. Now bell has gone. We will continue this topic tomorrow.